I told you just now to play the Sarali Varshai with flat notes without giving any oscillation to any of the notes. But you know, the Veena is an instrument which can be fully exploited. You have to play the Gamakams. And in this raga Mayamalava Gaula, the Gamakams are given to Ga and Ni. If not to Da and Ri also, but initially you can start off with Ga and Ni. And you play the Gamakams this way. A Gamakam is an embellishment or an adornment to a note where you play the neighboring notes as well. The note oscillates strictly, not in, restricted to the Ga pitch. It oscillates between the Ga and its neighboring. That is what lends its beauty. And the Gamakams depend on the raga in which all Gamakams, all notes are not oscillated. There are certain notes which can be oscillated for certain ragas, and you can learn this only with the passage of time by listening to more music. Now I'll proceed to play the first Sarali Varshai with the Gamakams. It's played plain. Just note, the second note, Re, is played flat. The third note is taken to Ga along. I glide it from Re to Ga with something called a Jaru. Jaru is a kind of Gamakam, which is a glide from the previous note to the note that you're going to sound. And then it is followed by a small oscillation, an oscillation played along the y-axis, as I told you. And the degree of oscillation depends, the deepness or the shallowness of the oscillation depends on the raga in which it is played. Re can be now played flat. I play Ma flat. Pa is always played flat. There is no Gamakam to a Sa or a Pa. It is called the Sthiraswaram. It is never oscillated. Da can be played flat, or it can be played in the Pa with a Gamakam, with an oscillation, which is called a Kampita. I oscillate Pa. See, in the Veena, if you pull it along the y-axis, you sound the next note. That is one great advantage. If I pull it along this fret, it produces the next note. And depending upon the extent of pulling, it produces the next neighboring notes. So I oscillated between Pa and Da to give a Gamakam for Pa. The Ni again can be played with a Gamakam and with a glide from Da. And just note that when I give the glide, I always give the meter or the pluck in the previous note. I don't give the pluck in that note. See, for Ga, I gave the meter or the pluck in the Re and then took my hand along to Ga. I actually plucked in the Re. Similarly, for Ni, I'm actually taking my hand from Da. I'm plucking while my hand is still in the Da. And then, with the strength of the sound that is produced, I'm taking it to Ni. And I'm not plucking again in Ni. I'm not plucking again in Ga. I oscillate between Ni and Sa. You know, there is a Ni here and a Sa here in the same fret. And then the Sa is played flat. Similarly, while coming back, similar exercises are followed. The Ni is given a Gamakam and the glide is given from Ni to Da. I'll show you when I play. The glide is given, or the Jaru is given, from Ni to Da. And when you come to Ma, the Jaru can be given from Re to Ma. And Ga can be done without a Jaru. And the Re can be given with a Jaru from Ga to Re. The two Jarus, the Jaru that goes up is called Egu Jaru, and the one that comes down is called a Digu Jaru. So you can actually see it. You'll learn more by watching this video. Now I'll go to the second speed with the Gamakam. No jaru is needed to be given in the third degree of speed.